Maggie G is pregnant and she's watching her reflection now in every window pane she slowly passes. Little does she know that the secret she caresses has been guessed by every mother in the high street. Maggie hasn't noticed that she walks a little tilted, and the coat she's left unbelted offers only partial shelter from the sympathetic eyes that follow Maggie G along the high street. Maggie is excited at the movements deep inside her, but her eyes betray she's frightened oh so slightly. No one felt like this before, she knows she's quite unique. She's sure that growing flesh has never grown like this before. Maggie craves for beetroot, craves for chocolate, wonders nightly if the bulge beneath her nightie needs the beetroot, needs the chocolate, and the blood that flows between them, blood that flows between them, through the cord that binds their life so tightly. Maggie is impatient, and the days and weeks of waiting make her wish she had a window to her baby. The mirror in the bathroom is supremely unrevealing, but confirms her in the feeling she looks ugly. Daddy G consoles her, says the mirror is a liar, says he loves a drum-tight hummock and the howler there within it, who will look like Maggie G, smile at every mother in the high street.